Kaladin clung to Teft's limp form and felt it all crumbling. The flimsy facade of confidence he had built to let himself fight. The way he pretended he was fine. Syl landed on his shoulder, arms wrapped around herself, and said nothing. What was there to say?
It's over. It's all just over. What is there to life if I can't protect the people I love?
Long ago, he'd promised himself he'd try one last time. He'd try to save the men of Bridge 4.
And I failed.
Teft had been so vibrant, so alive, so sturdy, and so constant. He'd finally defeated his own monsters, had really come into his own, claiming his radiance. He had been a wonderful, loving, amazing man.
He depended on me. Like Tien. Like 100 others. But I can't save them. I can't protect them.
Syl shrank in on herself. Kaladin wished he could shrink as well. Maybe if he'd lived as his father wanted, he could have avoided this.
I said I was fighting to protect. But I didn't end up protecting anything, did I? I just destroy. Kill. Kaladin Stormblessed is dead. I never existed. Kaladin Stormblessed is a lie. Always has been.
The numbness claimed him. That hollow darkness that was so much worse than pain. He couldn't think. Didn't want to think. Didn't want anything. This time, Adolin wasn't there to pull him out of it, to force him to keep walking. This time, Kaladin was given exactly what he deserved.
Nothing.
And nothingness. Benly watched the human, so consumed by his grief that he knelt there, motionless for minutes on end, and they all watched. Silent heavenly ones, solemn guards, disbelieving humans. No one seemed to want to speak or even breathe.
This is how I should have felt upon losing my sister. Why don't I have the emotions of a normal person?
She'd been sad, but she didn't think she'd ever been so overcome by grief that she acted like Stormblessed. Timber pulsed comfortingly inside her. Everyone was different, and Venli was on the right path.
Except there isn't really a point in returning to help now, is there? It is over.
Beside her, Leshwe descended until her feet touched the ground. Then she bowed her head. Show her, Timber Pulsed, what you are.
What? Now?
Show her.
Reveal what I am in front of everyone.
Benly shrank at the thought, attuning the terrors. One by one, the other heavenly ones touched down, as if in respect for an enemy. The pursuer shoved Liren into Leshwe's hands.
This is stupidity. I can't believe we're all just standing here.
Leshwe hummed to spite. Then, amazingly, she pulled out a knife and cut Liren's hands free. The pursuer pointed at Leshwe.
I have not forgotten how you tried to turn the Nine against me. You seek to destroy my legacy.
Your legacy is dead, defeated one. It died when you ran from him.
My legacy is untouched!
Venli stumbled back, afraid.
And this is complete madness! I will prove myself and continue my tradition!
No!
Leshwe passed the still gagged human to one of the other heavenly ones. She grabbed the pursuer, but he left a husk in her hand, exploding out as a ribbon of light to cross the atrium floor.
No!
The pursuer appeared above Stormblessed. The fused yanked a sharpened carapace spur off his arm. Then, holding it like a dagger, he grabbed the kneeling man by one shoulder. Kaladin Stormblessed looked up. Benly attuned the lost in return. The pursuer stabbed, but Stormblessed grabbed his arm and turned, becoming a blur of motion. He somehow twisted around so he was behind the pursuer, then found a knife somewhere on his person. Stormblessed slammed the knife at the pursuer's neck, who barely ejected from the husk in time. He reformed and tried to grab Stormblast again. Kaladin rammed his dagger through the pursuer's arm. A knife toward the face followed, and the pursuer ejected yet again. When Stormblast turned around, Remy saw his face, and she immediately attuned the terrors. Kaladin's eyes were glowing like a radiance, his face a mask of pain and anguish. But the eyes, she swore the light had a yellowish-red cast to it.
Like...
The pursuer appeared near the soldiers at the perimeter by the wall.
Go! Attack him! Kill him! And then kill the other radiants! Your orders are chaos and death!
The soldiers charged forward and shied away. They wouldn't face Stormblast in those eyes of his, so the pursuer was left with no choice but to engage. Venli didn't know if he realized that he was on his final body. Perhaps he knew he couldn't run this time, not and salvage any kind of reputation. Stormblast dashed to him, and they met near the vast window, flashing with lightning. The pursuer tried to grab him, and Kaladin welcomed it, folding it into the deadly embrace, then expertly slamming them both up against the window. Kaladin pressed the pursuer to the glass. The storm outside flashed, shaking the tower, vibrating it and splashing it with light. In that moment, Kaladin did something to the window. As he stepped back, he left the pursuer stuck to the glass, immobilized and lacking the void light to eject his soul. Kaladin didn't attack. Instead, he reached down and infused the ground, but with power that didn't glow as strong as she thought it should. The pursuer's head was pulling forward against his neck, his eyes bulging. Then he realized that Stormblast had infused the ground, then made it pull on the pursuer's head, but his body was stuck to the wall. Kaladin turned and strode toward the watching Heavenly Ones as the pursuer's head ripped from his body and slammed to the floor. Leshwi stepped out and met Kaladin.
Stormblast, you have fought and won. Your loss is powerful, I know, as mortals are.
Kaladin shoved her aside. He was coming for Venli. She was sure of it. She braced herself, but he stalked past her, leaving her trembling to the terrors. Instead, Kaladin strode for the Heavenly One who was holding his father.
Of course.
That Heavenly One panicked as any would. She shot off into the air, carrying the man. Two other Heavenly Ones followed. Stormblast looked up and launched into the air using the strange fabrial that mimicked the lashings. Emily slumped to the ground, feeling worn out, though she hadn't done anything.
At least, it's over.
But not for the soldiers from the pursuer's personal army who gathered around his corpse, dead a second time to the same man. His reputation might be in shambles, but he was still fused. He would return. The soldiers turned toward the infirmary, remembering his last orders. They couldn't kill Stormblast, but they could finish off the invalid Radiance. Above, Kaladin could barely see straight. He had only a vague memory of killing the pursuer. He knew he'd done it, but remembering was hard. Thinking was hard. He soared upward, chasing the creatures who had taken his father.
Kaladin!
He's managed to get the gag off.
Kaladin didn't actually believe he could save his father. It was as if Liren was already dead, and it screamed at Kaladin from damnation. Kaladin wasn't exactly certain why he followed, but he had to get up high.
Perhaps I can see better from up high.
Syl streaked ahead of him, entering the shafts that let lifts reach the final tiers of the tower. She landed on the topmost level of Yorathiru. Kaladin arrived after activating a second weight halfway through the flight, then swung himself over the railing and deactivated the device in one move. He landed facing a Heavenly One who tried to block his path. He left that Heavenly One broken and dying, then tore through the upper chambers.
Where? The roof. They'd make for the roof to escape.
He ran into the stairwell and up. He found another fused blocking the way. Kaladin slammed Navani's device into the fused's chest and locked it in place. He sent him flying away, up through the stairwell and off into the sky. Syl arrived, zipping around Kaladin.
Kaladin! I've forgotten!
What's happened? I can barely hear her.
But there was no time to waste. Kaladin burst out onto the top of the tower. The storm spread out around him. The last of the Heavenly Ones was here, holding Kaladin's father, fused back away.
Don't hurry, step closer, or your father dies!
Kaladin! I've forgotten the words!
Kaladin advanced on the Heavenly One, and in a panic, she threw his father out into the blackness, Kaladin saw Mirren's face for a brief moment before he vanished. Into the pit, the swirling storm and tempest. Kaladin scrambled to the edge of the tower and looked down. Suddenly he knew why he'd come this high. He knew where he was going.
I've stood on this ledge before. Long ago in the rain.
This time, he jumped.